One of the area's biggest football rivalries is coming to a head tonight. PG is battling Carmel for the shoe, a trophy that decides bragging rights for the next year, and not just among current players. This rivalry goes back. It goes way back. Our Aaron Clark is live tonight at Breaker Stadium at Pacific Grove with a little history lesson for us, Aaron.
A little history lesson for you, Dan. That's for sure. The Spirit bus just arrived from Carmel, so there's a lot of hooping and hollering going on. This is one of the biggest rivalries in the area, for sure. It dates back more than a half century. And in fact, the shoe dates back to 1949. It was the brainchild of a typing teacher, of all things, at Carmel High. Decided that would be a good idea to get it bronze, and that would be the trophy for the winner between the PG and Carmel game. But who knew that the shoe was going to take on, was going to be so big, was going to be such a symbol for these two communities? But it certainly is. It is a very big deal for whoever wins it. And even guys who have played in this game, say, 50, 60 years ago, they're still talking about it. The battle for the shoe. It happens every fall, a friendly and sometimes not so friendly rivalry between Carmel and Pacific Grove. Sometimes it goes Carmel red. And sometimes it goes Pacific Grove gold. PG actually holds a slight lead in overall wins, 32-27. But whichever way it goes on any given year, it is a big deal for that school. Here at Carmel High, the Padres won it last year. The shoe is currently under lock and key.
I think they have it locked in a room actually behind one of the alarm doors, so they did that like 2 days ago because they didn't want anything to happen to it.
Students have been gearing up for the game all week, but how much do they really know about the shoe?
I just know that the shoe came from an old shoe, and then it was like bronze.
It's the culmination of our season. Everybody goes to the game. Everybody looks forward to this moment all year.
I don't know anything about the shoe. I just know that I think we have it now.
Okay, so current students may not know all the specifics about the shoe, but these guys certainly do. They were playing when the shoe came about.
But it was our advisor, Lloyd Miller. We wanted a trophy that would represent the something to shoot for the big game with PG. Yeah. And so he found some old shoes, and J.O. Hanley, Tommy Hanley's father, bronzed them, and so that became the shoe.
Shoe was big news in 1949, front page news actually in the school newspaper. A night before, bonfire used to be part of the festivities, and then, of course, they always played the game. Jim Hare was the first Carmel quarterback to hoist the shoe in victory. Sadly, Jim passed away this year, but his buddies still remember him.
Jim was a very good athlete. He wasn't the tallest person, but he was very accurate. Yeah. And I was an end, so I always liked the quarterback.
Oh, yeah, there's many, many stories. You know, it was a family. It was such a small school.
Memories are a good thing. And when it comes right down to it, that's the real magic behind a smelly old football shoe that was bronzed back in 1949. And I've got to say thank you to Joan Vandervoort, who helped me track down all those old pictures. She put me in touch with the guys. We had such a great time talking to them. All kinds of old stories. It was really, really a special treat to take a walk down memory lane with them. Now, Dan and Dennis, I know this is very exciting, but I'll be back a little later in the newscast with my analysis of tonight's game.
All right.
It's coming up.
Hey,
can't wait.
Where is the shoe right now? Do you know?
The shoe right now is en route. We're told that, and I'm not kidding on this, there's a special convoy. They have actually decoy cars that go out. We don't know which one it's actually arriving in, but it will arrive sometime between halftime and the fourth quarter. That's what I'm
told.
What? Under lock and key in Carmel High.
No,
right
no,
now.
No, no, no. Get us
yes.
the shoe. We want to see the shoe. Go get the shoe.
The shoe. I don't have that much influence. Are
Come
you?
Come on, Aaron. You got
get
the connections. Go
the
get
shoe.
The shoe.
Maybe around the fourth quarter, I'll get the shoe.
Did you get to touch it earlier this week?
I did get to touch it. No, they opened up the vault for me today, and I did get to touch it. I did, yes.
Is it heavy?
It is heavy. It has a lot of names on it. It's been around for a long time.
Very cool stuff. All right. Have fun, Aaron. How about that field? Is that sweet or what? That brand new field at Breaker Stadium?
It is gorgeous. I am telling you, it is a beautiful, beautiful facility. Lovely place to play. You know, it's Friday night football. It doesn't get any better than that.
No. And the shoe? Are you kidding me? Go get the shoe.
I'll try.
Hey, last year I went to the shoe game in Carmel, and I said before the game, Dennis Lennon, TV News, I'd like to see the shoe. Ho, ho, easy, fella.
No.
No, that thing is locked in a van, and it'll be awarded after the game. Could I just see it now? No. Yeah,
Dennis is easy, backing me up fella. On this. They are dead serious about this. It's in a room with a
We won't be seeing the shoe in her next live shot.
So I understand why they wouldn't show it to him, but put on that Aaron Clark charm. Let's see the shoe.
I thought I was somebody, and they said, no, fella, you're not seeing it.